February is American Heart Month. Today, February 3rd, is National Go Red for Women Day. Heart disease is the number one killer of women. Here to tell us some of the myths and facts of heart disease is registered nurse and cardiac navigator Peggy Clurgett of Franciscan Health Heart Center. Peggy, thank you so much for coming in today.
Happy to be here.
We're going to have a little fun. This fact versus fiction, because you hear these myths over and over again, and it's hard to tell which is true, which is not. So let's go right to it, this myth versus fact. So myth, heart disease is for men, and cancer is the real threat for women. What's the truth?
Well, the truth is that heart disease is the number one killer for both men and women. 1 in 3 women will die from heart disease, whereas cancer, all cancers combined, 1 in 31 women. So it's much more prevalent with heart disease.
So women really need to listen up here for this, that is for sure. Okay, let's go to our next myth here. Heart disease is for old people.
And most people think that, but really, women of all ages can be affected by heart disease. There can be some hereditary things that they don't know about, and also younger women who also combine smoking with birth control pills, they have a 20% increase in risk for heart disease. Your risk does increase as you get older, but it can affect women of all ages.
It sure can. All right, let's go to our next myth. Heart disease does not affect women who are fit.
And isn't that a bummer?
Right.
You think you're doing everything right, you're exercising, but oftentimes some of the other bad habits like smoking or eating poorly, even though you exercise and your weight is under control, those other habits can counterbalance the good habits. So it's important to do all of those things.
Good. We're learning. Yeah, we're learning a lot here on this.
There are many stories of women who exercise and run marathons and still are affected by heart disease.
Absolutely. I've personally heard some of that as well. So I get that. And then here's another myth. I have no symptoms.
65% of women that have a heart attack had no symptoms prior to their heart attack. So it's incredibly important to know what the symptoms are. Basic symptoms for a heart attack are chest pain, pain going down the left arm, but women's symptoms can be very different. They may have a discomfort in their chest, but it may not be that crushing pain you see in the movies. Sometimes it's just a tightness or a pressure. Women are often present with shortness of breath. They may present more with nausea and vomiting and fatigue. And that's not a kind of tiredness. You worked out for an hour and you chased the kids all day and I'm tired. It's a strange fatigue. It's a fatigue that is unusual for you. Those are symptoms that you really need to pay attention to.
I'm not sure. Do we have any more myths to talk about? You know, here we go. Heart disease runs in my family, so there's nothing I can do about it.
I have heard this so many times throughout my career, and there is so much that you can do about it. Even though you have a family history of heart disease, taking care of yourself, following a heart-healthy diet, exercising can help, number one, push any problems that you might have further into the future, and maybe prevent them altogether. Mm-hmm. And then the second thing is, if you do have problems, you are more likely to survive them and get through them much easier if you take care of yourself.
Wow. Really quickly, we only have like 15 seconds left, but you know, some of those symptoms you describe, women are so quick to just brush those off and keep going with their day because they have so many responsibilities. What's that key piece of advice to tell women? It is something you need to check
Listen to your body. You know your body, you know what it feels like, you know when something doesn't feel right, and that's the most important thing. Talk to your doctors, talk to your family. Today I want everybody talking about this. Go out, tell your daughters, tell your mothers, tell your husbands, hey, did you know symptoms are different for women, so that they can help you when you have symptoms and help you recognize that it might be a problem.
Such great advice, Peggy. I can't thank you enough. You've educated us quite a bit today. Hopefully
My pleasure.
Help save somebody through this. Peggy, thank you so much. Thanks for what you do as well.